So what's going on, guys? Thank you so much for tuning into the Skater Informant. I missed you guys. Hope you guys missed me as well. So when will Corey Kennedy be released from prison? Short answer, April 2021. Yes, April 2021, which is basically 5 months from today, is the absolute earliest that Corey Kennedy can get out of prison. And that is already factoring in good behavior. It's also very important to note that once Corey is out from prison, he will still have to serve a year with an electronic monitoring device. It is unclear, however, if that means a house arrest type of situation, or a curfew enforced to him, or maybe even a parameter on how far he can go or wander off into the city from his home. That's still unclear, but what we do know is that he will definitely have a device attached to himself for a year once he is released. Now, speaking more on the court appearance back in 2018, it's important to note that both Alan Wade, who was a third person in the vehicle at the time of the accident, who actually walked away with a foot injury, and P-Stone's mother, Karen Majetter, both asked the judge to not give Corey any kind of prison time. I repeat, P-Stone's mother asked for zero jail time. And that's just because she knew P-Stone very well, of course, but also Corey. And she knew that P-Stone would have never wanted that. That's actually a formal statement she presented in front of the judge. But more importantly, P-Stone's wife, who is now a widow, along with her children, you know, tend to have a bigger say-so in the case because, again, she's a widow now. And she spoke directly to Corey in court, and I quote, "One day, you're going to have kids and you're going to understand the depths of this. I know you didn't mean to do it, and I love you." Even though that's a very, very compassionate, emotional, and serious statement she made to Corey, she still spoke on the prosecution side. So although she understands that this was a mistake, she did not suggest that Corey go with zero prison time. I mean, there was still a sentence that needed to be handed. Again, Cairo 7, the local news station, was the only station allowed in the courtroom that day. So I am definitely extracting this from an article one of the reporters wrote. I'll put the link below. But it's important to know that usually people with manslaughter, whether it's vehicular or just any other kind, tend to get 8 to 11 years. That is the average, sometimes more, sometimes less. But the lower side is tends to be 8. Well, Corey got 4. And that just shows that the community, the outreach, the support in the courtroom, the statements, it definitely influenced the outcome. This is not your traditional sentencing. Some people may call it, you know, a privilege of some sort. Some people want to say, well, that's just the community and proof that Corey wasn't an actual criminal. He was just a skateboarder. But regardless of people's opinion, regardless of what you think he should have gone or I think he should have gone, what is true at the end of the day is that he has served his time already. This is going to be done, a done deal, closing the books on that chapter or turning the page. And he has now an opportunity to start fresh. Now, once he goes back to regular life, per se, if that even is a possibility, given, you know, the events that took place. But once he is out, will he have a board sponsor? Will he have a shoe sponsor? Speaking on boards, my personal opinion, based on who, you know, the girl team is, it's likely that they may pick him back up. Just because he was not just a writer, he was a friend of a lot of the girl dudes. As far as shoe, however, I mean, he was on Nike, okay? And here is where that never-ending conversation from core and corporate brands comes along once again, is that If you ride, if your employer, if your sponsor is a gigantic corporate entity, they have to make decisions based on the corporation's policy. I mean, Nike, it's a company that sponsored Jordan, Kobe, you know, P-Rod, the biggest names in athletes, you know, in the world of sports. And then you have a skateboarder who just came out of prison because he basically killed somebody. Total accident, of course. But he was involved and he got a manslaughter charge. It is highly unlikely that they will pick him back up. I just don't see that happening. Now, I hope he does. Don't get me wrong. I hope Nike picks him back up. And I hope they give him back his signature shoe. But it is unlikely to happen. Now, will he have a hard time finding a shoe sponsor? Absolutely not. It's Corey Kennedy. People are begging for this dude to come out. And on top of that, he's super talented. So I don't think you'll have a hard time finding a shoe sponsor. I just don't think he's going to pick up his career back where he left it. So we just have to see that one play out. But I am super excited that in about 5 months, Corey Kennedy will be out, a free man, served his time, and ready to go back on his board, which is, I guess I would like to say, arguably one of the biggest things we're all hoping for when it comes, you know, to Corey. So definitely our thoughts to Corey, to his family, to P-Stone's wife, to Anna, to her family and her kids. Definitely such a sad situation, but hoping for the best. It's been a few years now, and it's time to, you know, pick up where he left off, and life goes on. So guys, this is the release date and a few other details around his release. Again, April 2021 plus a 1 year of electronic monitoring. And this is, again, this is standard. This is just formalities. Anyone that has or has been in any kind of manslaughter charge tends to have a post monitoring of any sort. That's just common for, I guess, the safekeeping, quote unquote, of the community, which we know that this is not the case with him. He's just a skateboarder. It was an accident, highly unlikely to repeat itself. But again, that's just the law. So guys, thank you so much for watching. Like always, I am the Skate Informant. You've been informed, and my job here is done. And I'll catch you guys on the next one.
Peace.